Hey, engineers. Learning how to manage our personal energy can help to increase our engagement, productivity, and overall good feelings. When it comes to completing P-sets, attending club events, and other activities, we may be familiar with time management, but what about energy management? Well, this microlesson will explain what energy management is and why it matters, how it works, and ways to start managing your own energy. First, think of a recent time during the week where you felt that you were in a flow state with your work, strong focus, feeling productive, with general feel-good vibes. Okay, now what time of day was it? For how long were you working without a break? Did you take a break? And if so, what did you do to recharge? All of this is involved with managing energy, and here's how. Personal energy management is the expansion and renewal of our energy, which we use towards things like assignments, clubs, discussions with classmates and peers, and everything in between, and which can be done through intentional replenishing behaviors and work routines that are strategically scheduled into our lives. In contrast to managing time, which is a finite resource, our energy can be renewed. Let's dive into the Untitled Rhythm. Maybe you're familiar with the Circadian Rhythm, which is our internal sleep-wake cycle connecting to the sunrise and sunset and occurs once within 24 hours. The Untitled Rhythm is also a biological clock, but with a 90-minute cycle that is repeated throughout a single 24-hour time frame. Nathaniel Kleitman, a groundbreaking sleep researcher at Stanford, first identified this rhythm more than 50 years ago as the basic rest activity cycle, the 90-minute periods at night when we move through the different stages of sleep. He observed that the same cycle occurred in humans even during the day. As we move through 90 minutes of intense work, alertness wanes, after which it's time for renewal, also known as taking a break. When we don't take a break and rather use caffeine and our stress hormones to continue, we can enter fight or flight mode, also known as the stress response. According to the Harvard Business Review, relying on stress hormones to continue intense work can result in the shutdown of the prefrontal cortex, a region of the brain involved with executive functioning. These consequences include thinking less clearly and ultimately experiencing negative emotions, all the stuff we don't want. But it doesn't have to be this way. In fact, success does not have to require distress. So, how can we start to manage our energy to promote optimal performance and well-being? First, begin to identify the parts of the day where you feel that you have the most energy. Are you a morning human, afternoon, early evening? Identify this first and then try to assign projects to this time frame that require the most creative thinking and intense focus. Next, identify the parts of the day where you have moderate energy. Use this for tasks like data entry or organizing the files on your desktop so you can love your wallpaper again. And finally, when are your low energy time periods? Use this time for non-work downtime activities. Activities like binge watching your favorite show. While in high energy task mode, try working in blocks of roughly 90 minutes, followed by 5 to 10 minutes of dedicated time on less creative tasks, like answering emails, and then take a true break. Think of a true break as your personal mitochondria. What activities produce energy for you? Perhaps it's physically moving away from your work for a 10 or 15 minute walk down Memorial Drive or inside your building, or to listen to your favorite playlist or podcast, or to talk to a friend or classmate about life. Whatever renews you. Taking a break can also mean initiating the relaxation response by taking a few deep belly breaths for about 1 to 5 minutes, or squeezing your shoulders up by your ears and then relaxing them back and down. Remember, personal energy is renewable and can be used strategically throughout the day to maximize both performance and well-being. There is no one-size-fits-all with this, as our energy schedule and break activities are unique to each of us. That's the great thing about being human. Find your flow and own it. To learn more about energy management, check out these resources.